Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. This channel is to share Rhino 3D knowledge to help students and 3D model professionals to learn various Rhino technique. Today we are going to talk about this door nut. It may not be necessary as jewelry, but the way of the twisting the shape, it will be applied to the jewelry and many other applications. Are you ready? Let's get started. Before we get started, I like to take a look on the Pinterest. If you go to the Pinterest and type it like hand forged, door knocker, twisted, those kind of keywords, you will get a lot of interesting twisting, very traditional blacksmith technique. A lot of this is being used in the jewelry. The way it twists is really, really beautiful. So the one I particularly like is this one. This is the one I think will be a very good practice on understanding how to manipulate the surface to get this shape. There are two ways to make this twist, and we are not going to model this guy, so I'm just going to temporarily hide it. What are two ways? The first, we can use the sweep one rail to create the profile and use the sweep one rail to create the shape and then mirror to the other side. The other way I found it is more smooth looking is using the simply just use the twist and flow it back to the surface. So let me show you the first one and see how I make the first one and the reason I'll choose the second one. Let's start with the circle on the top view. That's snapping the center to zero. So go to zero. And for the radius, let's type it 1.5 inch. So the diameter will be 3 inch. So let me type it 1.5 inch, enter. So we got this shape here. All right. And then we want to go to the right view and using the square rectangular tool to snapping the zero to the quadrant, and I'm just gonna eyeball it for see how big I would like it. Meanwhile, holding the shift key so that way it will be exactly square instead of rectangular. Okay, now if I'm going to work on this one, I would like to have one copy from the quadrant to the quadrant. So since it is going to be tapered down, so the one on the top is going to be smaller. So I'm gonna use the gumball to make it smaller, right? And then every time we are working, we're just gonna work on half of it because it's symmetrical. We can just mirror to the other side. So ideally, if I'm doing like this way, I'm going to go to the surface, sweep one, go from this point here to here. Then I will have something look like this. All right. So with this, I'm kind of looking, how am I going to make it twist? If I have a few more control points in between, I may have a better control on that. So my trick is going to find the curve, which is bunch of a square in between, and it's kind of work with those square. So the trick I'm going to do is to creating a surface right here, and with this surface I'm going to go to polar array and then selecting this surface, hit it zero for our center. And I would like to have number, I'm just guessing, probably 8 here. And then since we are only doing half of it, so I'm going to type it 180 degree. So then I will get those surface there. What those surface is going to do is going to help us to find the curve exactly where it is. So I'm going to the surface, going to the curve, and you have curve from the object, then you have intersection. Click on all the surface. We probably don't need the first one. We click on all the surface, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of them. We don't really need the very last one. So you kind of see there are intersection curve showing there. Then we can delete whatever the original surface is. So now those are the surface, it's being evenly out, follow it, you know. And not only it is evening out, it is getting smaller too. So the next one, we are going to use the same command as sweep. And we are going to use this as a rail, and we're gonna sweep from the first all the way to the very bottom, the very end one. Okay, so now you kind of see there's some sort of error going on. The first profile to the second profile, I'm not going to change in the arrow because I want them to be like smooth there. I don't want twist over there. And starting from here, I'm going to move the arrow to the next turning point. So this one is here and this one going one more, and this one will coming back here. All right, so you kind of see I'm moving everybody, follow the almost like you can already see the twist. It's kind of following, you know, the corner, and let's click on it. All right, so it gives us a good twist from the top view. However, when I'm looking at the side view, it kind of give me a little bit kink over there. That's the reason I don't like it, but it's a good way to understand, you know, how things is twisting. Maybe in your case, instead of twisting, moving from the point to point, you can move into the midpoint and that will be smoother. Okay, so you can try on those and get a few try to get the pattern that you like. I'm going to put this one aside just for the comparison. And then I'm going to make another one here. Alright, so the other one I'm going to try, I'm going to first of all delete all of this because we no longer need it. Okay, and then I only need to work on half of it. So on this circle, I'm going to split by the point, and then you're clicking on the quadrant and the quadrant. Alright, and I'm going to delete the other half. Alright, now we need to know how long is this one, what's the length. So I'm going to type it length on my command bar, and then I click on this one. Alright, hit enter, it show me is 119.695. so I'm gonna creating a straight line, and I'm gonna use exactly the same number, 119.695. All right, so now we get this curve right here. What I'm going to do next is to move this curve from the quadrant to the endpoint, and again moving this little one from quadrant to the endpoint. All right, and then we are going to simply just using the loft tool, or you can use the sweep one. Either one will come up exactly the same. So go to the loft and pick up this curve and this curve, hit enter, and then we will get something like this. Okay, and we need to make sure it's solid, so we want to cap it, type it CAP at the command bar, then you will get something like this. Okay, so the end goal is to kind of starting with somewhere not all the way to the end and not all the way to the other side of the end too. So we need to make sure our all snap is on, our near is on. Okay, now let's go to use the twist command. In the twist command, it will ask you the object, so we're gonna click on this taper one, and then you are starting twist. Make sure you're not snapping into the endpoint. We want to make sure that the endpoint is smooth, so we can copy, rotate it to the other side. And we want to go somewhere close to this end, but not the endpoint. So use the near, snapping there, and also use the near to snapping roughly here. Then we are going to look at the right view. Okay, I'm going to hold my shift and click on the 12 o'clock position, and I'm gonna go counterclockwise three times. So 1, 2, and 3. All right, holding the shift again and click on it. So now you can see we get this smooth, it's a lot more smoother than the one that we have here. Okay, well, this one has a character. I love this one too, but to make it almost, you know, identical to what we wanted to do, I will prefer using the twist. Okay, now let's flow this back to the curve. So the command we are going to use is flow along the curve. You just type it flow, and then it will ask you to select the object. We're gonna pick up this object. It will ask you to the base curve. Make sure you pick at the near one of n, okay? So I'm gonna click it right here. The target curve will be this n. All right, so that's how this one flows to the other side. And all we need to do is have this one and mirror to the other side. Make sure you're snapping into the endpoint. And all we need to do is just bowling it. And I hope you like the video, and please comment, like, and share. That really helped me on my ranking at the YouTube. That's also the way I can keep making free video for you. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next Monday.